to yet another episode of Willy's Garage. I have hooked up my small shop vac to a small dust extraction system, which ends up in the pipe over my workbench. And my plan is to use that small shop vac system to dust extract my power tools that I have behind me here. But there is a problem with having these cheap power tools. Every tool has different sizes on the dust extraction port. And I was thinking about this, and this has to be a perfect 3D printer project. I bought this vacuum hose with adapters from banggood.com, link in the description if you're interested. And it came with this adapter, which fits perfectly inside the vacuum hose, and it's easy and take on and off. I was thinking about copying the top part of this adapter and take it into Fusion and make some adapters for all my power tools. One other problem is that the vacuum hose I have in the ceiling over my workbench is a bit bigger than the one I bought on Banggood. Therefore, I need to copy the top part of the adapter and make it a bit bigger in Fusion 360. So, the first thing I have to do is to take measurements of the adapter I want to copy and take measurements of all the dust extraction port on the power tools I want to make the adapters for. So, now I just have to go into the Book of Secrets. I have 5 power tools I want to make adapters for. 4 of the power tools have circular output ports, but one of the power tools has an oval output port. So what I do on the oval is measure each sides. Here I have all the measurements for the tools. These are the diameters of the circular outputs, and these are the 2 sides of the oval output. Let's go into Fusion and make the adapters. On my dust shoe project for my CNC machine, I made a copy of the top part of this adapter. That's why I have it already on my computer. But, as I said, the vacuum hose that I'm using here over my table is a bit bigger than the one I used on my dust shoe. So I have to make the model in the Fusion a bit bigger. The way I'm doing this is just by clicking modify. All the surfaces I want to modify, and I add 1 millimeter. Here you see it's a bit bigger, and the bonus is that we get a bit bigger walls also, and a stronger part. I'm going to save this as a new file. For tool number 1, the inside diameter of my adapter needs to be 34.2 millimeters. Inside Fusion, I'm going to make this 0.2 millimeters bigger, so I'm going to make it 34.4 millimeters. This is just to have some offset and be sure that the pipe fits over the dust extraction port. So inside the Fusion again, the first thing I do is to make a sketch on this plane. Capture position. On this plane, I'm just going to copy this circle, the 2 circles that I have here. So when that's done, I have these 2 circles on this plane, and I'm going to offset this plane approximately 2 centimeters or 20 millimeters. This way I get a new plane 2 centimeters from this plane. On this new plane, I'm going to make a new sketch. And this sketch, I'm going to have the inner diameter of my tool, which is 34.4 millimeters. That was the inner diameter. And I want to make an outer diameter that is approximately 5 millimeters bigger than this one. So let's say 39.4. As you can see here, I have the inner diameter of my tool and the body of the adapter. So the way I'm going to do this is by going on create and loft. I'm going to loft from this circle to this circle and press OK. Here you can see I made the adapter, but I have no hole inside this adapter. So I turn on this sketch again, both sketches, and I choose loft under create, and I loft from the inner circle to the inner circle inside here. Choose cut and OK. That way I made a hole through. And since the dust extraction port on the tool is flat on every tool, I also have to extract the model I just made flat, about 1.5 centimeters. The way I'm going to do that is just by selecting extrude this circle and choose to extrude it about 15 millimeters, 1.5 centimeters. Well, here you see I have the whole adapter made for tool number one. So I'm going to save this as tool number one, underline 34.4 millimeters, which is my inner diameter. Save. Now let's open up the only pipe again. I want to make the adapter for tool number four because it has an oval. I'm going to do it a little bit different. So, but first, anyway, I make one sketch plane on this circle, capture position, and I just draw out the two circles that I have on this sketch. The keyboard shortcut for a circle is C, so that's what I use. Here I have those two circles. I can click stop sketch. I go in on that sketch and click offset plane. Offset the plane by 20 millimeters. It's the same procedure as the last one. And I click a new sketch on this new plane, like so. Since this is an oval, I have to draw a square first, so I get all the sides there. This one is going to be 26. I have to remember to add 0.2 millimeters. So this one is going to be 26.4 millimeters. This one is going to be 28.2 millimeters. After I have created this new sketch on the new plane, I go to the rectangle tool and choose center rectangle. On the center rectangle, you know where your center is, so you start the rectangle in the center. One click and you have a rectangle, like so. This side to be 28.2. Press the tab button. And the other side to be 26.2. Okay, so the next thing I do is to go on the tools here and choose a spline, fit point spline. You can see it snap on the center of the square here, and the same it snaps in the center here. From this center, I click spline. I can adjust this later, but I just take it up to this point and to the center point here again, and press this green button to disengage the spline. I want to make more splines, so the same again, from the center point to this point to the center point. Disengage. I'll do the same here.
This point to center point, disengage, spline, center, this point to center.
Disengage. Okay, so there you have it. Now I can remove this square that I made. I just do it like this and press the delete button and remove it. The next thing I need to do now is to make the outer diameter of my adapter. So I press the C button and make just a normal circle about 5 millimeters outside the spline, like so. As you can see now, I have this circle, which is the body of my adapter. So let's try to do the same as we did with the other one and create a loft from this circle to this circle. And we press OK. That looks quite OK. And we go on sketches here. Turn on both sketches. Create new loft from the inner circle to the inner circle there. And put it on cut. OK. Here we have the adapter. Can turn off the sketches again. And as with the others, I want to extrude 15 millimeters more, just to get a straight edge on the inside of the adapter. Let's save this as tool number 4, underline 28.2 millimeters, underline 26.4 millimeters. Save. So now you have seen me make one for this regular circle tool and one for the oval tool. I'm going to make 3 more now in different sizes, but I'm going to do it in the same way as I did with the first tool, because they all have circular dust boards. Time lapse. All of the adapters. Now I need to export them as STL files so I can take them into Cura and make G-code files for my 3D printer. Of course, I'm going to include all these files in links under this video or on my website. Just check out the description underneath. Let's start by exporting tool number 1. We go to the Make 3D Print. I do not want to send it to Cura straight away. I want to make a file of it. So I do like this. And select the model I want to export. When that's done, I press OK. And I put it in the project folder. And I will call this tool number 134.4 millimeters. Save. Then I go to tool number 2. Same thing. Make 3D print. Not to Cura, select the model, click OK, tool number underscore 39.2 millimeters.
Do the same with tool number 3.
Now I'm ready to import all those files in Cura and make G-codes. I first open one of the files. Here I'm inside Cura. I already have set it on my 3D printer, Creality CR10, and I have the quality on low quality. I could even put the quality on draft. So I'm going to put it on draft quality, that's 0.2 millimeters per layer. As you see, the model is on its side, so I select it and rotate it 90 degrees like so. And I can move it to the side. This is tool number 1. I also want the other tools in this same project, so I just select everyone. Drag and drop. You see everyone is on the same side, so I just select everyone. Rotate it 90 degrees. Like so. And I can move a little bit around, move them a little bit around there, like so, back on the back. I'll put it on layer view and prepare. When I hit prepare, it starts slicing the project, and that means it makes all the layers for my 3D printer, and therefore calculating all the G-codes. Processing layers. And here I am on layer view. I can view all the layers down just to check if I think everything looks okay. And yeah, I think this looks good. But as you can see in the bottom here, I can put these tighter together. The best thing is to put them together so that the brim that I have in the bottom here connects to each other. As you can see now, the bottom brim is touching each other. This way, all the models have a better connection with the build plate, and there is less danger for the models to tip over and mess up the 3D print. And here we have them. Through movie magic, they are finished. So let's get them off the print plate. Here you really can see the advantage by getting the brim I have down here to connect to each other. This way the whole assembly and all the models are going to sit tighter to the work surface. As you can see, I also printed these models with 100% infill. This means that it fills plastic inside all the walls. Before I test them on the tools, I of course need to check if they fit the vacuum hose. And as you can hear, it just clicks into place and it sits quite good there. So this is going to be very nice. These are tools number 2 and 3. They had the same diameter of 39 millimeters. Let's check if the adapters fit. They fit just fine. This is tool number 4 on my list. It's the one I'm most excited about because it has an oval output port. So let's check if this fits. I think it just needs a little bit of precision. Oh yeah. It's a tight fit, but it does fit. Next, I'm going to use some quick drying epoxy to fasten the adapters to the tools. I used equal parts of base and hardener on the epoxy. Okay, let's do this. Not going to use a lot on each one, but just a thin layer. Like that. I'm just going to rotate it a bit to get the epoxy all over. Like so. There. Next one. Next one is the oval one. Final one is the jigsaw. Yeah, all the adapters work as they should, and I'm quite happy with this. If any one of these is broken, I'm just going to print a new one and attach it. Or if I buy another power tool, I can just make a new adapter for that tool and print it, and it will fit my system. This is a very good and cost-effective way to use a 3D printer. So, that's it for this time. If you like this video, please check out my next video. And as always, have a nice day. Goodbye.